Did you press that button, Gaz?
I didn't press any button, Charlotte.
Well, why are we sitting here like this in this funny angle?
I don't know. I don't remember coming downside. No. Oh, hang on a minute. Hang on, Charlotte. I've exhausted.
Hang on. What are you doing?
See, all it was at the cameraman and the camera was on its side. Be the right way up.
Oh, I see. Good morning, everyone.
Yeah, morning. Welcome to Get Fresh.
Gilbert, how are you? You're in a bit of a mess.
Flibble.
And it's all right, because I'm not supposed
to be here.
Flibble, flibble. You just twist this around like that. Yeah.
Guys, and then it's, pump,
it's not as
pump.
Good. There you are.
Plip, flibble, flibble. Now.
I'll give you a flip, flibble, flibble. Get your head round,
lad. How's that? Yeah, it's a lot better than looking round, isn't it?
Yeah. We've got a spatial anomaly this morning. Let's hope the outside is
level. Anomaly?
Sure,
I thought she was in Coronation Street.
I'll see you later.
Come with us, you. This is going to be good. I think there could be
a nice lovely day. Good morning.
Good morning.
Everyone.
Oh, this is brilliant. Where are we, Charlie?
We're at Bewley at the National Motor Museum. And, you know, there's everything here.
Oh, yeah, they've got a palace, haven't they, over there?
Well, that's where Lord Montagu lives.
Yeah, and they've got cloisters.
Well, that's where, the site of an old abbey, where the monks used to live.
They've got ponies?
Yes, because we're in the New Forest, of course.
Ah, and they've got a monorail.
I'm hoping to go up on that later on.
Oh, very nice. Right, listen, I'm off to find things.
See you later.
Because there's going to be loads and loads of cars here this morning. Where there's going to be good cars, there's a strong chance there's going to be some brilliant driving. In fact, there's an advert on telly at the moment which got some good driving in it. You may have seen this, I'm not actually too certain. But a guy spins... Oh, that'll be him now.
The theme of Get Dressed this morning is space. We have two wonderful examples here. And to judge Get Dressed throughout the morning, we have Helen Carter and Deborah Conway. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
And
they've come all the way from Australia. And
just
they're in
to judge this competition.
No, they're actually in a band which is called...
Do-re-mi.
And they're going to play the video, which is also called...
King of Moomba.
We'll look forward to that, seeing that later on this morning. But if you're in the Bewley area, why not come down to the National Motor Museum, dress on the theme of space and join this lot, and we'll see you there.
Fellas, chaps, would you mind... Who are you?
We are the three musketeers.
I am Athos.
I am Porthos.
And I am Aramis.
But there's only two of them.
Live music this morning comes from the Christians. Good morning.
Morning.
We have Gary and Henry, and what are you going to sing for? Overwhelmed by the crowd there.
Yeah, a bit underwhelming, of course. Really underwhelming.
What are you going to sing for us this morning?
We're going to sing the American version of Forgotten Town.
And?
And Born Again, the new single.
Oh, great. Well, you can actually have a cup of tea now. Have a rest.
With Gilbert.
With Gilbert, yeah. I'll see you later. Yeah. Not only the Christians with music this morning, but we've also got Prince's new video, which is called Alphabet Street. And we've got a very strange thing, parachuting teddy bears. If you're in the Bewley area and you've got a teddy bear, bring it along, it could go parachuting.
Very strange.
You're closed this morning. Oh, what are you doing eating a banana?
Oh, this is wonderful, this one. It's actually all to do with sport, ADC, because there are serious problems in the country where bananas are grown. There's one island, actually, the whole industry is growing bananas. There's major problems there. Charlotte, look
and
at that.
Spot. Oh! Fabulous, Paracenters. I didn't know we had Paracenters.
Oh, you'll be doing that. The Sport Aid film happens later, all about David Grant. You're going Paracending.
Me?
Yeah.
You never told me.
Yeah, you're going Paracending. You love it.
Said.
Here's Galaxy Rangers. I hope you've got clean underwear on.
No, this is
you'll be
fair.
All right. Trust me, Charlie. Trust me.
Put those weapons away! We want to take this guy by surprise!
With that money, we can get a whole fleet of Andorian hyperdrives. What the?
Someone at the door, Binbot.
I said put it away!
Sorry, Chugga.
Let's get down to business!
Get set! Veggie Man!
Yeah.
You got the stuff?
Well, if you're buying, we're selling. See? Super Trooper juice. Straight from the World Federation DNA labs.
There ain't but a handful left in known space.
Now, Veggie Man, let's see your cash. Stand still! What's the matter with you?
Hey, what are you hiding?
Ugh. What is that?
Hi there.
Where's the money?
You see, well, that is, we never carry cash.
We always leave home without it.
That's too bad for you. Get rid of him.
May we come in?
Ah, it's a trap!
What kept you?
We're after the overboss.
You'll get nothing from us.
Round them up.
I gotta dump the evidence.
Hold it right there. It's gonna blow! Maybe I can save something. Do your stuff, Pathfinder.
Okey-doke, Doc! Entering the system! I'm in! Looking for any data in particular?
Access any codes for the overboss. Hurry!
Doc, there's no time!
Everybody out!
How about this stuff?
Grab what you can.
Doc, come on!
Pathfinder, we're leaving.
Suits me fine!
You cut that pretty close, Doc.
We want overboss, don't we?
We could try my method.
Put him down, Goose. Relax. I think I've got a way to get to overboss.
Uh-oh. Another stroke of the Doctor's genius?
Amazing, isn't it? I just hope Commander Walsh buys it.
Commander, another call from Senator Gans.
All right, put her on.
The Super Trooper program ended years ago, but smuggling of those illegal DNA samples could spell the end of the League of Planets.
I assure you, we have several leads on the overboss. We'll get him.
I'm putting you and your Galaxy Rangers on notice, Walsh. The board is ready to chop heads on this one.
Okay, let's hear it.
Here's what Pathfinder got out of that data droid. We know the overboss operates out of Tortuna. He learned the Queen of the Crown wants the Federation's only sample of Super Trooper juice. This stolen sample is on the way to her empire now. The Super Trooper juice would allow the replication of mutant armies. The overboss has hired Brappo to hijack the shipment for him. All we have to do is hijack the shipment first and use the samples to get to Overboss. He wants them so badly, he'll have to deal with us.
We prevent the Queen from obtaining the Super Trooper DNA, plus we trap Overboss. Good show.
The Crown ship will stop to refuel at that base.
So the Queen thinks.
Tozo, you and Waldo would endanger our cover. You're out of this one.
We reluctantly concur, Commander.
Zachary, you'll need a juice detector from Longshot.
Right, sir.
The future of the League of Planets may be in your hands.
Doc and Nico will take care of the refueling station. I'll go for the Super Trooper juice with the Goose.
All these people here belong to a group called The Front. And one of the members here is No, it's not an an alien head, sort of lizard. It's, excuse me, are you in there?
Yes,
hello? Hello?
Hang on a minute.
Can you get that off, to you? Bill Sinclair, good morning, Bill.
Good morning, Charlotte.
Have you had an accident, what do you think?
Yeah, a little bit of an accident, yeah.
Tell me, what exactly is the Flaunt?
Well, we're a multi-arts collective based in Lancaster, and as you can see, we make all these different kind of processional images and puppets and so on. And we do big bonfires and processions and that kind of thing.
The sort of puppets that you wear, like this head thing.
That's right, yeah.
Tell me, how do you go about beginning to make one of those?
It's quite simple, really. You start off with a bundle of these things called withers, give them a good soaking so they're nice and bendy like that.
Yeah.
Build up a framework like they're doing over here. This is Fran and Anna.
This is a first stage.
Yeah, they're working on an elephant's trunk over there for the later.
What's
on in
this?
The an elephant's trunk, that is.
That's going to be an elephant.
You'll be amazed when you see it.
Fine. Right. And then what's the next stage, Bill?
And then you start covering it with paper and glue.
I don't know what I'm standing on here.
And then you end up with something like that, which is an upside-down dragon at the moment. As you can see, that's Nigel.
That's why I can't tell what it is, because it's upside down.
That's right, yeah.
And finally, over here behind, you end up with something like this.
You end up with something like this, yes. A whale, would you believe?
And what do you do with them once you've made them?
Basically put them on and leap around. Make a lot of noise, a lot of colour, you know.
And so you're going to have a procession of all these puppets?
That's right. Later on in the programme, what we hope to do is get a load of kids together.
Well, you seem to have plenty of helpers, so it should be fairly spectacular.
I look forward
to seeing that later on this morning. Good grief.
Allow me to introduce you to the chap who owns and runs the National Motor Museum here at Bewley. This is Lord Montague. And a rather special friend. This is a real treat for me to drive along in this car. I feel like I should be in a race or something. This is wonderful. Well, hello, everybody. Hello. Okay, apply the brakes. You have plenty of warning if you're going to brake with this car. Will you shut it down, Lord Montague? Lovely. That was a real treat. Thank you very much. Who's this, then?
Well, this is really one of the most important cars in the museum. It's Britain's oldest racing car, a 1903 Napier, which we brought back from America last year, which was a good thing for the museum. And we had a public appeal, and we're still about £30,000 short.
So have you got any spare cash? We want to buy this for the museum.
It's
rightfully back in Britain. Can I just show it? Can I steal you a moment? Shall I steal you? Or you? You, I think. Come here. Come and have a quick look at this. There's some very interesting bits down here. Just talk us through some of those, Lord Montague.
These are the oil drip feeds, which goes to different parts of the engine. There's another little oil reservoir, and oil again. That's the ignition switch.
I love the ignition switch. It's like
and
a light
this
switch.
Is...
Wonderful horn. Listen, Lord Montague, thank you very, very much indeed. Good luck with the museum. I should go and come here. I want to show you some of these cars. I'm going to show these chaps these cars here. Here's something interesting I just remembered. Do you realise they had car phones in these things? It was just a thought. Right, this is a 1909 Rolls-Royce Silver Ghost. And did you know that this lady, the Spirit of Ecstasy, is actually based on a lady who worked here and actually worked for Lord Montague's father a long time ago at the museum. Fascinating but useless facts about cars from me, Gaz Top, number 37. Now, over here, can I show... If I was a television presenter or an incredibly wealthy pop star in the 30s, I'd probably have one of these things. Is this an Auburn 851 supercharged? Now, they didn't have turbochargers in those days. They had superchargers, which did basically the same thing. And if you're really flash, you'd own yourself one of these and you'd look the business driving around California in something like that. White wall tyres as well. It had very fashionable to have white wall tyres. This, talking of pop stars, this is actually owned. This is a Spano Suiza, about 1929, and it's owned by none other than Paul McCartney. Popular lad, apparently. He was in a group called the Ruttles or something. But he owns this and has loaned it to the museum because most of the cars in the museum are owned by other people and loaned. So that's why it's important to go to the museum. Come over here because there's a wonderful car. Not all the cars here... Oh, you're up there. Not all the cars here are old. This is from 1982. It's a DeLorean that was built in Belfast. It's got a Peugeot Renault, what they call the PRV, 2.8-litre engine at the rear. A very, very, very lively car. It's got gullwing doors. Appeared in the film Back to the Future. Did you know that, Back to the Future? But they didn't make many of them. The company went bust, so that's why this is a rarity and why it's in the museum. Look at this stainless steel body. And I must say, I am absolutely in my element this morning, all these cars. I think it's gorgeous.
Now, what's happening?
Welcome all to Get the Record. Today we've had a letter from this man here.
Shall I read it?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Dear all at Get Fresh.
That's you.
I am the world champion at bag racing.
Uh-huh.
I would like to challenge all at Bewley.
That's you.
To a suitcase race.
Aha! Uh-huh. And this is a good Lord, there's somebody in it.
Oh.
Aha! Porthos!
Yes, Athos, I wrote that letter.
Oh, really?
I am the world champion and world record holder bag racer, and I'm challenging all comers here at Bewley to a race around the park in a suitcase.
So, really? That's the challenge? A suitcase racer around the park?
High speed.
At high speed. Now, I tell you what, Charlotte.
What?
We're standing here, Richard's down there, I've got a pint of milk over here.
Oh.
And I say, we drench him.
Poor Athos.
I prefer beans. We go faster.
Okay. We ride for Camelot!
Forward, ho!
This lot are completely out of their minds. And no, get the record, we'll be going all morning. We're going to get all this crowd at Bewley to have a bag race challenge. No. That's later on.
What?
We ride for Camelot!
What? What? Getting in bags and doing all that stuff and that. Essentially, yes. And all that.
Apparently they do.
Does it make you go nicky nicky patang patang?
Yes, it does.
Oh, good. Yes. I'm glad about it.
Hang on, I want to introduce you to two people who just come in.
Come in. See,
there's a reason why they
don't
wait.
Don't feel shy.
Come in. Sit down.
Don't feel shy.
Sit down. I'm going to have to use this mic on you, okay?
Take the weight
off
your bulletins.
That for the moment. Yes. Will you please welcome from number 73, Mr. Harry Stern!
Yay!
And Lee Coates. How are you doing, Lee?
Yeah, all right, so.
You entered a competition or something. What's it all about? What was the competition?
Well, you had to answer these questions, then write a story about the journey across the Alps that Hannibal did.
Now, you answered those questions, it was on 73, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was the most complicated competition in the world. Anyone that saw it, you might know. It really was hard, wasn't it? And this boy, brilliant storyteller that he is.
But what was the prize?
You tell him.
Well, the prize was to take care of the elephants going over the Alps.
So you went down to meet everybody. Where did you actually go and join them?
In Turin.
We went to Turin.
I don't know, I haven't tried so far.
We went into Turin.
I phoned him up, but
and,
I don't know.
And it was tough. We did about, how long did we do? It was about 25 miles. I mean, when you think that there were some people that were walking for like, they were walking for months, bless them.
You haven't seen this? Have a look at this, right? This is actually the film. We'll have a look at your feet in a second, Harry.
Yeah, just have a look at his feet. Oh, it's good television, isn't it?
Can I introduce you to Lee?
Lee, hello.
Remember, Lee won the 73 competition.
That's right.
And you gave us the message by television from Australia.
That's right, yeah.
And he's the brilliant elephant expert, who's my assistant.
Right, you're looking after David today.
Yeah.
You'll need a lot of help there.
No, Lee. Ian's become quite an expert, Harry. Yeah.
Oh, right, Lee, look.
Come on now. In you go, Lee. And right, you do the same.
Now, push it right inside her mouth. Darling. It's all right, don't be scared. Come on, push your hand in. There, see, look, you're lovely tongue.
Come on, Harry. That's it. Good lad. Go on. Ian, do you think you yourself have learnt anything more about elephants on the expedition?
Yeah, I think apart from anything else, though, you realise just how intelligent the animals are.
And I've noticed that more and more you refer to them as your girls, and you go to see them first thing when you arrive at the start every morning. Do you think they're recognising you?
I'm sure. I mean, I get the once-over with the trunk.
Yeah.
And for some reason, they always go to my feet, which I can't for the life of me think why. But no, they seem to know who you are.
Well, exactly.
Our champion!
Yay! Champion!
Well done, Sam! Well done!
He did so well. You're quite used to walking as well.
It seems to me that you're actually walking really fast, aren't you?
It's not just a walk, it's a march that you do. And the most amazing thing when we started it, that the feeling of like camaraderie between the people is amazing.
Well done, my son.
They all have their own personal sort of like reasons for doing it. But they're all for one course.
With legs twice your length.
Leukemia research.
Brilliant. That's not very. I don't think it's made clearly enough. Leukemia research benefited from the walk. Have you met Gilbert now, Lee?
I don't know.
Listen. You got to.
I'm proud of you.
You're a bit of a cricket fan, aren't you?
Yeah.
Who do you support?
Yorkshire.
Yorkshire, I thought, yeah, mate.
Oh, I'm overcome with emotion. What are you going to be now? A professional walker or are you going to be a professional cricket player?
Walker, I think.
A professional walker. Superb. You two, well, thanks very much. Something else, one final thing. You brought something back
from that at home.
Well, I won't get it out here.
No, let me get it out now.
Loaded up downstairs in the Get Mucky bucket. It's actual elephant muck from Harry and Tyrion. Well done, you two. Oh, don't get mucky. Oh, no, don't call me Gary either. Oh, that was terrible.
Get Mucky.
Give us a G. Give us an A. Give us a T.
First heat of Get Mucky. Let's meet the four guys. They are, for the Blues.
Claire Mitchell.
And what do you like doing, Claire?
Horse riding aerobics.
Good luck to you. For the Reds, we have over here
Kelly Burke.
And what do you like doing, Kelly?
Swimming.
Good luck to you. The blue boffin is over here
Sarah Cushion.
And what do you like doing, Sarah?
Playing the organ.
Good luck to you. The red boffin is
Kelly Miller.
And what do you like doing, Kelly?
Collecting stamps.
Good luck to you. Face your screen. So let's hear for the Reds.
Yeah!
The four guys are trembling. Boffins, are you ready? Let's give them a countdown. Up, three, two, one. Away they go. The Blues have scored 3,190. But the Reds have scored 5,330. Yeah! So have a break. You take a trip to the tray and quickly. You're unlucky, because you're going to get mucky.
Yeah! Get mucky.
Surprise, surprise. And we got a lot of plastic on the show this week. Hang on a second. Let me get in here. Oh, grief. Give it a stay to me. Excuse me, can I squeeze in there next to you? What's your name?
Ian.
Ian, you've got the job. You're the new presenter of the programme. Ian, ask Isu what their names are and what they do. All right. You ask this chap what his name is.
What's your name?
It's Dave.
Now, you got to hold the mic. Try that again.
What's your name?
It's Dave.
And ask him, what's your name, sir, you say?
What's your name?
Dickie,
right. You come and sit here with me. Are you any good at puzzles? Come and sit down here with me. Well, I'm hopeless. What is all this all about, fellas?
It's called chain reaction.
What you got to try and do is you got to make cubes out of six pieces. Any six pieces go together and make a cube. If you watch Dave, what he's doing now, he's making a cube. He'll try not to slip. When you've made one cube, then you've got to try and make harder shapes and beat certain times that's set. The fastest time for making one of these is 3.5 seconds.
Crikey.
Then you've got to try and make a blob. It's the hardest one on the lot, and that's just 100 minutes.
All right.
Between that, you've got a chain, a knot, a crab, a gooseberry, all the different shapes as well.
I'm going to have a go at doing this. Ian, you're now going to be a presenter again. You hold on to that, mate. You hold on to that so they can hear me. Now, hold it everybody so they can hear me. I've got to... Show me how you hold this.
Right, OK. You've been pretty...
I don't know if you can see this. You'll have to move your mic to that side so they can see this.
Just
one
two
there.
Two together like that.
Two together like that.
And put another two on.
Hang on, I've lost it already. One across there at the bottom. Doesn't help being partially dyslexic, you know, being able to do this. Right.
One across the top.
One across the top.
You're going to do it?
I think so, yeah.
Hold them together.
I'll give up. Listen, you guys try and make a billion of these and wrap them everywhere. In the meantime, here's Gary Wilmot and the new presenter of Get Fresh. It's this chap, Ian. What's your last name?
Aiga.
Now we know.
Two brothers bought themselves a couple of horses. One of them said, "Hey, look, how are we going to tell the difference between these horses, Silas?" Silas said, "I know. I'll cut my horse's tail off." He said, "All right, then." And he did, too. Well, old Benny thought, "That looks good. I think I'll do the same with my horse." So he cut his horse's tail off. Old Silas says, "That was a silly thing to do," he said. "Now how are we going to tell them apart?" Benny said, "I got an idea. You have the black one, I'll have the white one. I did it!
Oh, are you all right, Teddy? Oh, good. This is Greg Locke and Diane Locke. Now, they parachute teddy bears all over the country from great heights. And I've lent them my dear Eric. Are you all right, Eric? This was made for me by a very special person, by my grandmother. And you're going to parachute him. What are you going to do? What are you doing to him now?
Well, I've just tied his parachute on and we're going to drop him from 100 feet.
He's afraid of heights. Now, pass him to Greg. Greg, what do you do now?
Well, first of all, Eric, I want a good clean exit.
Good clean exit, Eric. Are you listening?
Proper stable position.
What's that, Eric? Do you know the proper stable position?
Got to get your back arched, haven't you?
Oh, back arched.
And don't forget.
He's a bit humpbacked. The count.
4,000.
4,000. Can you count to 4,000? It's a bit like 10, only more. Okay.
Then check your canopy. Make sure it's all right.
Check the canopy. Okay.
I do want a good landing. Feet and knees together.
He's only got one foot.
Foot and knees together. Come on then, Eric.
And he has to go. How? What does he have to count?
He's got to count 4,000. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. Check canopy.
Check canopy after that. Are you right? Have you got that? Well, whilst you attach him to the kite, which we're going to send up in the air, I'll catch him later when he's parachuted and collect his certificate for you. See you later. But whilst they're doing that, come and have a look at some get-dressed people, because they're over here, standing in the field. Where else do you put space? Because there's lots of space
here. Here we are again.
Hello, ladies. Who have you got here?
We've got Karen, who is Space Girl with no arms. No arms on this Space Girl.
Oh, you have got.
Oh, she has got arms. She's been fooling me. This is Sally, who's another Space Girl with stars.
Turn around. Sally, are you sisters, do you think?
No.
You're not?
We're just friends.
Friends. It's amazing because your hair is exactly the same,
incredible,
isn't it?
Incredible coincidence, isn't it? Extraordinary.
Helen, who have you got over here?
Holly.
Hello, Holly.
Who's dressed as a space kitten, I believe.
What
a very cold one as well.
Are these ears? Cake wrappers. Lovely. Yeah. Well done. And over here we have a lovely lady. What's her name?
I've forgotten.
What's your name?
Laura.
Laura. Well, that's great, isn't it? Mars. Mm. Not the planet.
I think her dad had something to do with that, didn't he, Laura?
We'll be seeing lots more Get Dressed later on. Have you had a look at some others?
Absolutely. We've got a meteorite over there, which is very exciting, which we'll be seeing later on.
Well, I'll leave you in the space and go over here because the teddy bears should be parasending. See you later, girls. We've tried all sorts this morning. We've tried parasending. We've tried hot air ballooning. We've tried kites. And... oh, you're up there. Hello. How did you get up there? Anyway, we've tried everything in our powers to get these teddy bears to parachute this morning, but they don't seem to be having any luck. But I'm just going to check that, see that my teddy bear's all right. I'm very worried about it. It normally hasn't gone outside the bedroom, you see. He's not used to heights and things. But while I check that, have a look at the Christians, some live music with Forgotten Town. See you later. Here we go.
Bye.
Splendid music from the Christians there. More from them later on Get Fresh this morning. And Gilbert meets Michael Jackson. Well, kind of. See you later for more Get Fresh. Until the meantime, go yo! Yo! See you then. Break, break, break.
I know it can be a bit of a problem. It's the altitude, you know. It's the altitude of the whole problem. Oh, there he is. Look, it's Desmond Fortress Buttress, one of the bravest flying men I ever saw. Oh, you're so brave, aren't you? It's brave. It makes me cry. Here, it's that air up there. It's so thin. It's so thin you could almost not see it, couldn't ya? I saw you coming down as brave and swift as an arrow through the skies like a... like a teddy bear, really, on a parachute. Hello,
I see you've met Mr. Fortress Buttress.
Oh, I've met Desmond Fortress Buttress. He's a fine man, isn't he?
Gilbert, this guy's called geezer, this guy's called Car Crash, it says on there.
Oh, a car, that's his nickname, isn't it? Car Crash, as in Neville.
Fine. Yeah. Neville Car Crash. That's you right. Obviously know Neville.
Well, I know what I'm talking about out there, don't ya?
Yeah.
All right.
Listen, you know that car that I was in earlier on?
Yeah.
The Napier?
Yeah.
Have a look at this. This is actually the Napier Racing. You like this.
Oh, you've got some film of this, Gaz?
I have, yeah. Okay.
Let's have a look at this.
Look at that.
Oh, it's funny about it. They're all in olden times, though, aren't they, them and that?
Well, that was way before breakfast this morning.
Oh, it's peaky there.
It was very hairy. It was very, very kind of hairy, frightening, all that.
Very hairy side of the road there. There's a hairy bloke there.
They were doing about 60 mile per hour, and that was like serious speed in those days.
It's fast then, though, isn't it?
Yeah, they thought it would kill you, just travelling 60 mile per hour.
What if you were underneath a thing? Yeah, definitely.
I think that's a fair comment.
I think that's
a
fair comment, but never mind.
But they actually genuinely thought that if you were in a car and you went over more than like 30 mile per hour or 30 minutes,
Desmond?
It would kill you.
Desmond,
bizarre.
What's that all about?
There's a thought, isn't it?
There's a thought. Where is it, Gaz? That thought.
I brought it with me.
Oh, did you?
Meanwhile, the future of the entire League of Planets was in the hands of the Galaxy Rangers. As Zach had gone off looking for Super Duper Juice with Goose, apparently.
Top priority for her ships. Her cargo ship is to be refueled as soon as it arrives.
Yes, sir.
Tripwire, go make sure all the alarms are deactivated.
Wait, Doc!
Firefly, short out the internal weapon systems.
Gotcha, Doc!
A manual lock. Talk about primitive.
I thought the doctor could fix anything.
Any suggestions?
Yes, step aside. This feels about right. You may applaud.
First, let's knock out the beacon.
Sure this'll work?
It'll overload fast, but it'll last long enough. There's Doc's signal.
Okay, we're in business.
Let's get our ship into position.
Captain, this beacon doesn't match with sector profiles.
Probably getting some gravitational lensing. Maintain your approach on the beacon.
Yes, sir.
When the crown ship comes out, we have to be in the right spot.
You worry too much.
Ready to go to sublight.
Proceed. Happening.
We're in the middle of a planetary ring.
Go to full shields.
When you see an opening, take it.
Just watch me.
Shields are failing.
Engines, emergency power to the shields.
Now for some light exercise. I hope Overboss appreciates our trouble.
This way. Is just ahead. They must be getting ready to offload it onto a destroyer.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, hold it right there.
Got it.
Captain, look what the hull monitor spotted.
Galaxy Rangers, alert security.
Detected on deck 7-1 in damaged spacesuit.
Decompress that area now.
They're blowing the atmosphere.
I'll stay and slow them down. You get the juice out of here.
Don't give me that. I can get along without one, I think.
Goose, you don't know whether you...
Do it while there's still time. Come on, little implant.
Goose!
Seize the Ranger vessel and put us back on course.
The Ranger ship has just powered up.
Welcome back. Thanks, buddy.
What's next?
We rendezvous with Doc and Nico on Tortuna. They're putting out the bait now.
Here at the Bewley Motor Museum, because there's also this fantastic monorail which is 60 feet above the ground and gives you a beautiful view of the whole museum. You can even go through the museum and have a look at the exhibits. But there's fantastic, you can see the Millennium Dustbin and the palace, everything. And hang on, is that a beaver?
We are the Three Musketeers.
I am Athos.
I am Porthos.
And I am Tom Brown Schooldays. And you join us just in time to witness an amazing aerobatic feat with a beaver.
And this is Billy the Beaver.
And this is Billy's trainer. Hello
Billy's
there.
Trainer.
Now, could you tell us in a nice, clear voice, what is your name?
Kelly.
Kelly. And this is Billy the Beaver.
And how long have you been training Billy the Beaver? 20 years!
20 years! Kelly, would you like to tell us exactly how old you are?
Four.
That's incredible.
That's impossible.
Right, what's going to happen now is Roland here, holding the Billy Beaver. Billy is going to leap from her hands across the air and eventually smash through a hoop of solid...
newspaper! But of course, Billy is very small and very, very, very timid.
Okay, so what we want for little Billy here, is everybody here to shout out a big countdown from 5 to 1. After which, Billy will leap through the hoop. Okay? So you're ready for this?
Yes.
Here goes, don't worry about this. You ready?
Are we all ready?
Ready, go!
Five, four, three, two!
Athos, stop!
What?
Kelly has just informed me that Billy will not be performing the stunt unless he has a regulation safety harness.
Aha, the safety harness. Here we go, here comes the safety harness.
No, we do have a safety harness.
Yes.
We do have a safety harness. We have to have the safety harness.
Special safety harness.
Because otherwise, Billy will shoot off into orbit and it takes Kelly 20 years to catch him.
20 years to catch him. How many times has this happened, Kelly? Just once, apparently. Not surprising.
So,
okay, are you ready for this?
Hold on.
Here we go. Now, Kelly, are you ready?
Yes.
Porthos, are you ready?
Yes!
Audience, are you ready?
Yeah!
Billy, do you want to go to the toilet? Well, it's too late now. Okay, here we go for the big countdown. Are you ready? Five, four, three, two, one, go!
Get dressed this morning. The theme is space. Wearing blinding sunshine, I can hardly see you over there. Now, Deborah and Helen from Doremi are judging.
Here we are again.
We'll start over this side, I think. We'll start way down here. Now then, who is this?
This is Julia.
Julia.
Whose father has very, very cleverly made a Milky Way.
Julia, that is very good,
does
but...
does not work for a well-known chocolate firm, as far as we know. Mind you.
It doesn't say what you think it says, okay?
We're on ITV, not the BBC.
That's all right. I like that, because it's kind of... your dad let his imagination go wang-ang when we said space. Now, over here... What's your name, sir?
Kenny.
Do you know who the Galaxy Rangers are, then?
No, but Kenny's been trying to explain it to me. He's been blasting away.
Give us a... blast that camera there. Can you do that? Just riveting action, really, this morning on Get Fresh. Meanwhile, who's this, Helen?
This is Chris.
Yes?
And Simon, and they're joined at the meteorite.
Fantastic.
It is good,
joined
it?
At the meteorite. Find out if they win Get Dressed later this morning on Get Fresh. Well done. We're out of time. Brilliant.
Oh, get mucky!
It's the second heat of this morning's Get...
For the Blues, we have...
Isaac Warrington.
Isaac Warrington. And what do you like doing, Isaac?
Football, please.
Football. Good luck to you. And for the Reds, we have over here...
Lee Hagen.
Lee. And what do you like doing, Lee?
Judo and football.
Judo. I'll keep away from you, then. Good luck. The Blues, we have...
Mark Cole.
Mark. And what do you like doing?
Watching telly.
Watching telly. Well, watch that telly. The Reds, we have...
Mark Cox.
Mark. Another Mark. And what do you like doing, Mark?
Computers.
Good luck to you, you shouldn't need it. Let's hear the Reds!
Yeah!
And let's hear the Blues! Yeah! They're going mad here. Let's give them a countdown. 3, 2, 1, get back here! Away we go! Mark, that's watching telly, so you should be fairly good at this. With the Galactic Monster. The Reds on my right have scored 5,560, but the Blues have scored 6,590, which means they're playing Take a Trip to the Train. You're unlucky, so you're gonna get unlucky!
Oh, get mucky!
This is probably the fastest washing up bottle ever in the entire universe. The first ever land speed record holder, this car. The man here, Alan, who's Alan, I call you Alan from now on, Andy. What and who was this and how fast did it go?
Right, it's 65 miles an hour, electric car, and the man is called Giannazzi.
And that was when?
1899.
1899, cars already start to go fast. I like it the way it's streamlined, that's interesting.
Yeah, but unfortunately, the man stands up in the middle and ruins all the streamlining.
It kind of ruins the streamlining. Now, this is the most beautiful, let me put that there, machine. What is all this?
Right, this is a Sunbeam. It went 203 miles an hour. It's got two aircraft engines in it and a giant chains, like bicycle chains, to drive the wheels.
It sounds a bit hairy, bicycle chains.
Yeah, it's very dangerous. They didn't discover till it went about 200 miles an hour that it could break. And a man, in fact, in a car like this, had his head cut off when the chains broke and came through the bodywork.
Ouch. This is the first car ever to go beyond 200 miles per hour.
Yep, that's right.
And you know, there's actually production cars these days, like the Lamborghini Countach and stuff, which smash it up. Production cars didn't go that speed. If it wasn't for cars like this, they wouldn't be able to do that kind of speed. What's this, Andy?
Right, Golden Arrow, specially designed for high speed. It's streamlined, shaped like a dart, went 231 miles an hour.
231, when was that?
1929.
So it's quite a fast vehicle in its time. That's beautiful. Yep. But this has got to be this beautiful blue machine here. It's got to be the most famous land speed record holder. Tell us a little
about it. Right, okay, it's Bluebird. It's the first of the big jet cars. Donald Campbell took it to 403 miles an hour in South Australia.
Fantastic. This is jet powered, but the wheels were powered. It wasn't just like a plane that we didn't have wings, which is the exhaust coming out the back.
That's right. No, the wheels are driven by this engine, and later on the rocket cars then just use pure thrust to push them along.
Now then, the current world land speed holder is not here at the museum, but tell me a little about it.
Right, the current land speed record breaker is Thrust 2, made locally in the Isle of Wight, and it went to America, the Black Rock Desert, and went 633 miles an hour, and that is the fastest a man's ever been, official.
It's very dangerous, the land speed records, isn't it?
Yeah, about three quarters of all record breakers get killed, either in their cars or on boats.
Luckily, Richard Noble is still alive. How long do you suppose that he's likely to hold the land speed record?
Well, there's a lot of people in America with lots of big, fantastic ideas, and so who knows, 1,000 miles an hour soon.
Wow. Thank you.
Go proper like that, do it.
It does, my car does go fast.
It don't go like that, though, do it?
It does, it goes fairly fast. How fast do you need to go?
About 4 million in Trinity, Finity, million nil.
Have you finished?
No.
Now, do you remember the competition we had about Finn McCool and what the giant from Giant's Causeway actually looked like?
Yeah, nice here, Charlie.
Well, Gilbert has got some entries here. Here are the runners-up.
Yeah.
Gilbert, do you like this one?
I like
it.
It's so funny, isn't it?
It's wonderful, isn't it? This is great Uncle Gilbert, the giant standing on the Giant's Causeway. That's by Ian Kane, he's age 8. What do we have under here?
Well done, Ian. Well done, Ian.
Very aggressive looking giant, actually. The Scottish giant, who was very aggressive, of course. That's Daniel Freer, aged 13 from Leeds. And finally, the other runner-up, third runner-up is... A rather
Frank Sidebottom.
One from Andrew John, aged eight, I think, from Nottingham. It's wonderful. Nice. They're all going to receive Giant Causeway games.
Sure,
Gilbert.
that'll get
them
quaking
and
excited.
Those?
Haven't it,
do you want to send them those?
Oh yeah, okay. Oh, it's an insult, really, but never mind. There you go.
Gilbert, there you go. Watch it.
Oh, sorry, Charlie.
Now it's time for look at a brand new video from Prince. He's the master of the pelvic wiggle. Gilbert gives a wiggle.
Get the record and the great suitcase race. Shut up, Porthos.
Yes, and now you join us for the suitcase race, but who are the other contestants?
The challengers.
Hang on to that, my man. Now, you, sir, could you tell us in a nice, loud, clear voice, what is your name? James Hunt. We have James Hunt. Well, nice to meet you, James Hunt. I'm glad you could take time out of your busy schedule to be with us racing today in the great suitcase race.
And you, could you please tell the audience in a loud, clear voice, what is your name? Nicky Lauda, ladies and gentlemen. Nicky Very Lauda. Fine, Nicky Lauda here. And now you, could you possibly tell the audience in a loud, clear voice, what is your name?
James.
Boadicea.
Well, what a terrific race we're going to have. Boadicea, Nicky Lauda and James Hunt. When the flag goes down, what James Hunt will do is race up to the bag. A technician will help him into the bag. He dives forward into the bag. The technician zips him up. And he races off at great speed around Bewley Park in a suitcase.
For 37 laps, ladies and gentlemen.
Lovely. Well done, James.
Okay, now, while we're here, let's have a look at some of the vehicles.
Well, the vehicles are quite simple. 42,000 litres, turbo zip, and, of course, fully convertible.
And how about some of the cornering?
Well, the stitching on the cornering, superb, as is the handling.
The handling's very good. And now, what about the... where's your car, Richard?
Well, this is mine. This is my E-type bag.
E-type bag.
Petrol consumption's very good on the motorway's long journey, but even better round town for just shopping.
Shopping. Right, and now, so, this is the champion. These are the vehicles, these are the contestants. Join us for the great bag race.
The great
very shortly.
Race. James, good on you, matey.
Change for table six. That's a tea bag. What's the matter with you?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't get any sleep last night.
Have you tried counting sheep?
I did. I counted 5,004,072 of them.
What happened then?
By then it was time to get up.
You want to try this? It's a marvellous book. It'll give you an instant cure for sleep.
Ooh. Instant sleep can be achieved if only you chant these ancient mystical words. Hum nam de pam de hu. Hum nam de pam de hu. Hum nam de pam de hu. It's not working, is it? I said it's not working.
Ball and a kick.
Hang on.
Again.
Sorry.
Ball and a kick.
You may remember we've been running some competitions on Get Fresh. Inundated with entries have been brilliant.
What inundated?
Inundated means we had a lot of them.
Yes.
Watch it. Watch that nose. I don't want it anywhere near this jacket.
We did a thing in Ireland about Finn McCool. We asked you guys to draw some of them. Have a look at this.
I showed you some of the runners up. Well, this is the third runner.
I like that one.
I like this. This is from Robert Blake, who's from Barton in Oxford. Who's 55 and a half, I think that is.
We're going to send him like that one. Giant Causeway game. But the winners.
The winners, these are brilliant. This one from Alexandra Kent, who's 12, from, I think that's Teague in Staffordshire. Yeah, maybe Leek, it's probably Teague.
It's the giant, and when the little lady here blows, the Scottish giant's kilt goes up like that, and he's got frilly knickers on.
Brilliant! I really like that one, really like that. And the other winner is this one, which is from Stephen Richardson. Chester Lestrange, County Durham.
It is live,
County
folks.
Durham. I love the detail on that one, Charlie, don't you?
That is excellent.
So you two winners
get one of these wonderful cartoon
and
drawings.
And aren't you quaking in anticipation out there? I bet you are.
Thank you, Bill. One, of course, of Gaz as the giant, which is signed, and one of me in the pram as the baby giant. And Gaz running away from sheer terror. We're going to frame those and send them to the winners. So thanks very much
for
that.
But that is not all. There are more competitions, you see. We ran this Gilbert meeting superb moments in time, superb people kind of thing, competition.
Do you remember that, Gilbert?
These are the two I want you to see. Have a look at this. This is from Scott. I think that's... I can't read it. It looks like Foydie or something. From Bristol.
We'll go out in the garden.
That's it. We'll have a drink afterwards.
On the roof.
And that is Jim Bowen from Bullseye. My mate Steve Allen will love that one. I know that.
Do you like this one? This is Gilbert meets Rick Astley, who's getting mucky at the same time. It's not easy, is it? Well done. And that is from Stephen Gregory from Nottingham, age 13. Well done to you.
Very good, Steve.
And this one, this is from Matthew Jones from Swansea in Glamorgan. That's Dennis the Menace. Gilbert Great Miss Dennis the Menace. The prize
I don't like that
breakfast. Have breakfast with Gilbert. Now, you won't be difficult with him. The address, Gilbert, please, the address.
You want the address, do you? Yeah, get it over there, pass
this it. Is this is the address. No, this is the address.
Oh, my God, you're Gilbert's sacked. 1 million, London, WC 99.9. I'll see you guys after the break.
After the break. Stunt cars and everything.
Break.
pecking away all morning. We've got quite a menagerie of animals here. Bill, go, right. Hello, have you got one? Come over here, I can see this is an elephant.
That's the elephant you saw earlier, right? Amazing, isn't it? Look at the transformation there, right?
It is incredible.
It's incredible. Yeah.
Also the giraffe.
There's a giraffe. There's Dave and Nick working away on a giraffe there. Looks more like a giraffe now, doesn't it?
Do you have to have your face painted before you can work on these?
Oh, yes, it's compulsory, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
It looks like fun, but hang on, what's this?
This Getting is up. Mandy
There's
the
a stirring.
Whale. This is Strawberry Girl the whale.
What, the whale?
Strawberry Girl, he's called.
Strawberry Girl. Hello. How are you in there?
I'm fine in here.
Is it heavy?
Weighs about as much as a small whale would weigh.
Weighed
at the whaleway station this morning.
Weighed him at the whaleway station. Fine. Oh, dear. But the dragon's head, I can see, is quite fabulous now.
Incredible, isn't
and look, what's
breathing. Wow, look at that.
Bill, that's incredible.
Yes.
I didn't realise. So it's not just
true.
Puppets, it's actually very lifelike.
On the edge, Jan! On the edge, Jan, here you go!
Oh, I almost... Chaos reigns wherever we go. Gaz, yes. Can I just ask you a question?
Yes.
Why have you got this huge globe?
Oh, Charlotte, I am glad you have asked me that. Come and sit down here and I'll show you. Come and sit there down. Sit there down. And if you've seen this, we've got a spare camera over there. Can I steal that chap over there? Have you seen all these wonderful people who are sat around here? Very well behaved. All right, stay there, team. Listen, let me get back to all this.
Here
sit you
are.
Down.
Found
sit
it.
You down. If you look at this, you see, Sport Aid have been away making films and things for everybody,
yeah.
You see. And the reason why I'm making these films is to see why and where the money is going that Sport Aid raised once you join, you see.
And
now
how
then,
it's helping people.
Some of the money has gone to this place here called Dominica, which is just kind of down from North America and just up from Brazil. Okay, there's serious problems in Dominica concerning bananas and things like that. This is Get Global, which is a film with David Grant explaining the problems that they're having just about there.
Hi, this is Dominica. Great, isn't it? Land of natural beauty and sunshine. Paradise on earth, some people call it, and a lot of young people live here. In fact, over 80% of the population are under 45 years old. Oh, and they've got lots of these as well. But I tell you what, if you're young and you live here, paradise isn't always as easy as you might think. Most of the bananas that we eat back at home come from here. But to me, it's a banana. To the people behind me and to the other people on this island, it's their lifeblood. Without them, they don't survive. We're talking about surviving, one day something happened that nearly ruined everything.
So far, Dominica is the only island that has been devastated by Hurricane David. At least 4 people were killed here. At least 400 people are homeless. 12,000 acres of bananas, the country's entire crop, were destroyed.
The wind was roaring, thunder was rolling, and lightning was flashing. So, at that time, I was scared, you know, but I'm not all that scared because I did not know what was happening.
Grand Bay was just flat. Many houses were down and a lot of people, the school was crowded with people. We used it as a hospital for those who were injured.
But that wasn't all. After the hurricane, they decided if it ever happened again, they were going to be ready for it. And this is part of the preparation. This is a school garden. You see, this garden isn't just decoration. This is where the food is grown. Who grows these, the students or the teachers?
The teachers show the students in what way to do it, and then the students now just complete the entire work plate.
Sport Aid 88 is already funding self-help projects like these for kids in parts of Africa. With your help, we can do more. Yeah. Look, I tell you what, I actually enjoy the other end of this, which is the eating. And this will get it eventually, so why don't I leave you to finish this? And why don't we go and see what they do with it once it's done? This is where it all happens, and this is Madrina Moses, who runs and supervises the cooking. So is that all stuff that you grow here?
Yes, everything is grown in here, or we buy from the farmers, from the local farmers.
Are you trained to do this, or do you
yes.
just decide to come along? And
no, well, we have seminars, and a dietitian comes over, and you know, we have the classes and lessons to know as to what to cook and how to cook, how to prepare the meal for the children.
By the way, are all the cooks here mothers of children who attend this school?
Most of them.
How about you?
I am.
How many kids have you got here?
I've got 2.
So you see, everybody goes to school here, even the parents. Unfortunately, although the kids have exactly the same ambitions as you or I, they don't have much choice.
Farming is about all that's left if they're going to survive. Sportaid 88 is trying to put some choice back in their lives. Little Nadia is only 9 years old, but she's already chosen the greatest career in the world. What do you want to be when you grow up?
A songster.
A songster. So can you sing?
Yeah.
Go on then.
I love you. I want to feel you from my side. I need you, got to have you lonesome, baby. Season change, people change. I feel you have tomorrow, baby, seems like yesterday, yeah. Feeling change, people change.
The girl's a star. What do you want to be if you don't become a singer?
A farmer.
There you go. It's not really surprising that we've got cars because we're here at the National Motor Museum at Bewley. But what's special about this car? Well, maybe not a lot, but you watch what it can do. Go for it, big man. There's a ramp in front of us. Whoa! Now then, this takes some doing. You will notice that I was held firmly then. The reason why Russ had his arm across me in the chest there, he's actually feeling the car. Oh, hang on. We appear to be going completely the wrong way. You may have seen driving like this on a well-known TV commercial, but the thing about the person on the TV commercial is that they didn't have to speak whilst doing it. Watch the DeLorean, it's worth about 10 bob. And the chap that's doing this driving is rather good at it. Thank you very much, Russ Swift. Now, if I'm right, if that was just like the advert, everyone's supposed to break into spontaneous applause. Russ Swift, the man who did all that. Before I ask you various things, there's one thing I do have to do. I need to have a lie down for a minute. That is very... Where did you learn to do that?
A spark called auto testing that you featured a couple of weeks ago in Ireland.
That's right, we did a bit of that.
I've been doing that for about 20 years.
You're reasonably good at it, are you?
Yes, we've won a few championships.
Yeah. Just a few? Just a few. Is this a straightforward car then? I mean, do you have to have it modified?
The diff's locked, so you can drive on two wheels, and the suspension's stiffened, so it's a bit more predictable to handle. The path, and it's absolutely standard.
Right, I notice it's a little bit bouncy. You've got some big, serious, thick tyres on and stuff. So what do? You drive for various people showing these stunts and things?
Yes, we go all over around the country and all over Europe, and do shows like this,
You get to travel around the...
Oh, yes.
Let me show you something. It's in the family stunt driving. There's a chap over here. There's yonder, a young mister. Who is this? Paul.
This is eight. He's Paul. He's eight. Yes, he learned how to do this last year and has been...
He's nearly got up then. I know he can do it. Go on, throw it round. Yeah, we got plenty of time. We could do this again. It's worth seeing this. Would you agree? How do you feel about someone so young driving as hairily as you do?
It's not hairy at all. He's got a safety bar on there, and if he did topple over too far, he would just fall onto it. So he wouldn't hurt himself at all.
I like the idea of that.
But it looks good.
Give him a round of applause if he gets up this time. I think he will. Go on, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. There we go. And he's up. Never mind. Come here, Paul. I know he can do it because he was whizzing around during Galaxy Rangers earlier on. You going to park there for me, Paul? You going to park there? I love this. Have you seen this? The stabiliser bar. That's brilliant. You safe in there, sir?
Yeah.
Crash helmet and everything. Now then, can you give me a lift towards the ship? Because Get Mucky happens downstairs. Can we go... the engine stopped. Give us a push, someone. These things happen on television.
Get Mucky!
The gruesome gunge is ready. It's worse even than Gilbert's snot. And it's ready to pour on the unlucky finalist in this morning's final of... Already, who's gonna win? Could it be Fall Guy Isaac and Boffin Mark? Or on my right for the Reds, could it be Fall Girl Kelly and Boffin Kelly? Let's hear for the Reds! Yeah! And let's hear for the Blues! Yeah! Boffins, are you ready? You do realise that you are competing for the fabulous, the fantastic, the amazing Get Mucky Trophy! Yeah! Everyone wants one. Now, you're playing a much more difficult computer game this time. So let's give them 3, 2, 1, Get Mucky! Away they go in this morning's final. The screen's a purple, that means it's more difficult. Don't ask me why. I don't know why. It just is. It's more difficult. I'm losing.
two Kellys have scored 4,770. And the Blues have scored 7,880. Liz, well done. You're unlucky, so you're going to get lucky.
Get mucky.
Okay, here we are. And as promised, we've got Michael Jackson here. And unfortunately, he's got a little bit of a throat problem, so he can't really say very much, but I'm sure he means well, you know what I mean? That album Thriller, right, that sold well over 100 copies, didn't it, that? And did very well for it. Well done, Michael, well done. About a little song. Go on, then. Oh, baby, I love you, like everything in the world. Yes, that's a hit. It's a sure hit, Mike. It's a surefire hit. And we were the first ones here. Oh, get fresh to get it here. It's Michael Jackson. He's my mate. He's my mate. Honestly, he is. Honestly, he's my
mate. Oh, I've got you. He's still trying to teach me how to do this chain reaction thing. It was saying, you squeeze them together, it stays together. He squoze it fell apart. Richard. This is going to drive me wang-ang! It's worse than Rubik's Cube, this.
It's nothing new there, Gaz.
Look at this! Lovely decorations, they link them together.
This is my new...
Come and have a look at this. Richard, show them this. Have you seen this incredible chain that they've done? Chain reaction in your shops now, and if you're really good and you've got a lot of patience, you can just keep going forever and ever and ever and ever and ever.
We are the Three Musketeers.
I am Athos.
I am Porthos.
And I am Billy the Beaver.
And today what we're going to do is we're going to demonstrate the power of Porthos's tiny mind.
Tiny brain by evaporating two huge buckets of water into thin air.
Thin air.
Absolutely disappearing.
And how are we going to do this? We're going to use this using nothing but an ordinary plastic bag.
But I know what you're thinking. You're saying, what about the bag? Has the bag got a false bottom?
A false bottom?
Well, no, I can show you the bag doesn't have a false bottom.
Actually, no, I'm not thinking that. I'm thinking, have you got a false bottom, Porthos?
Has Richard got a false bottom?
Ah, well... No, I know what you're thinking.
That's quite
what about Charlotte?
Solid.
Has she got a false bottom?
No,
I haven't got a false bottom.
Well, sorry about that. Right, I now proceed to give the bag to Aramis.
Thank you, Aramis.
Certainly, D'Artagnan. And now I take the bag and I take a perfectly ordinary bucket of water. And to prove that this water is perfectly ordinary water, I'm going to drench this child over here. See, it is water. Okay, yes. Entirely blue. I now proceed to put the bag, the water, into the bag.
Okay, in goes the first
bag
bucket.
Number one. That's lovely. Okay.
That's lovely.
Into the
bag. Okay.
Okay.
That's lovely.
And now I take bucket number two of the water.
Right.
And then that goes to the bag.
In goes the second bucket of water.
And now the water begins to evaporate.
And it's evaporating.
It's disappearing.
It's evaporating away.
The thin air is going.
It's magic.
That's magic. We bought that trick up Paul Daniels.
It cost us a fortune, actually.
Look,
I'll report you to the magic circle.
Porthos! Porthos, that trick was never any good.
That's I'm going to leave them trick. To it, taking a notice of them, because over here is a lovely lady called Jane Tripp. Good morning, Jane.
Good morning.
Now, you were going to be parasending this morning, but you sent somebody up.
Yes.
And there they are. We can just about see them coming down here. Is that your dad?
No, that's Ken Rains.
But you have sort of like a family unit who all go parasending, or Sportlight.
Yeah, it's my dad, my two sisters, and my mum observes.
Your two sisters, how old are they?
One's 13 and one's 6.
And they go parasending?
Yeah, they love it.
When did you start?
I started when I was 6 years old.
Well, must have taken a lot of training. What sort of training do you have to do?
Not a lot, really. I mean, it takes about a day to do the square ones. But the round ones, I mean, anybody can do it.
Anyone?
Anybody at all.
Well, I think Ken's about to join us once he's sorted this parachute out. But tell me, can anyone, handicapped people go parasending?
Yeah, sure, anybody. We've had people with one leg, no legs. Anybody can do it.
Thank you. Ken, well done.
Thank you.
What was it like this morning? How were conditions?
Very difficult. Very difficult. Wind was veering off to 90 degrees off the wind. But
Well, I went parasending once, actually, a while ago, and I landed in a tree. Is that normal?
No, not normal. Very, very unusual.
I should have been with you, shouldn't I, really? Thanks for parasending down. But tell me, Jane, you've actually broken a record. What is the record?
The record is for duration is 1 hour, 27 minutes, 17 seconds.
You stayed up there for 1 hour. Mm-hmm. How high are you when you're up in the air?
I was about 200,000 foot.
2,000? I think I'll stay on the ground. But now time for a joke. Here's Gary Wilmot with a great appreciative audience.
Johnny was writing his thank you letters to his uncles and aunts for their Christmas presents when suddenly he stopped. "What's the matter?" said his mother. "It was on the tip of my tongue and now it's gone," said Johnny. "Well, if you concentrate hard enough, it'll come back," said his mother. "No, it won't," said Johnny. "I swallowed the stamp." I knew you'd like that one.
Get it?
Oh, dear me. This chap was just stood here. I can't see the camera or anything. He's wandering around like this.
This chap, I think, is not a chap, actually.
Who's in there, then?
I think it's not a chap.
Turn around this way. What's your name?
Vicky.
Vicky, a serious... Did you make that?
No, my mum did.
Well done, Mum. That's a good outfit. So, have you picked some more, then, for us, girls?
This is Mark over here. I'm not sure what Mark is, but he's looking very impressive.
What are you, Mark? Have you got any idea, mate?
A space robot.
I think you probably are a space robot. Boop, boop, beep, beep. Hello. Oh, it works. It works. And the skill that's
over
gone into
here,
this one.
We have Fiesta.
Would you like to give us a guided tour? Come round here, my love, so
Fiesta.
We can see you.
Fiesta's looking like she's sucking up chocolate milk there.
What have you got in that tube?
Nothing.
Oh, well, I think we better put something in there for you. We'll give you some orange juice later.
Yeah.
How are you doing over there, Helen? What have you got?
We've got,
turn around this one.
Isabel.
Is you Isabel?
Yeah.
Hi. Izzy, you look like a certain green friend of mine inside the ship. You're not from Drill, are you?
No.
Where are you from?
Space.
From space?
She's from Mars.
From Mars?
She's from Mars.
Well, you can, in fact, get a bus from Mars to Drill, where
really?
Gilbert comes from. Apparently, so I'm told. That is very good. Did you make this?
Help my mum.
You helped your mum. There you go. Team effort, worthy of it. But this is.
I've got a cup of tea on the top here for you.
Oh, well, I'll have a slurp of that later.
I forgot to mention Galaxy over here.
Look at this.
This is the third part in the series, I believe.
Third part in the series. Yes. That is good. You must be related, Julia. You two, into the ship. There's an alien who wants to speak to you. Off you go, quick. This is a band called Do Re Mi. And this is a single and a video called The King of Moomba. Who's going to win? Get dressed.
West meets east, a shining example. Throw arms around the earth. Drunk boys are in voice, all kings of the gutter. I'm an alien here in the country of my birth. Hooked up to the Cumberland heartbeat, drip fed at your feet. It happens in my head, my body cannot move, and I'm not a very pretty sight to see.
English.
I hear all the girls from Doremi, Deborah and Hannah.
Hi.
Girls?
Just getting friendly.
Getting fresh, actually.
Oh, right. I like it. On the ball.
Helen, I'll talk to you. Yes, that's your touchable one here. What exactly is King of Moomba?
It's a festival that they hold.
He slimed me.
This painful world without love.
Look, I can't talk seriously about the single here.
Girl, but you're snotted all over her DNA.
I'm not waiting for you.
I know a very nice alien that would be very interested in you.
Oh, yeah? Who's that?
It's terrific.
Funny, isn't it?
Yeah. When you look at yourselves on the screen, yeah. We've got all the sort of Carmen Miranda hats and doing all the... and swimming through the band. Do you ever think...
Yes, all the time.
What do you think when you're looking at yourselves?
Oh,
you always pick up, you know, a little zit or something that you thought you might have. Or you always look for the worst things. I think particularly in that area, we actually look rather good.
Well, no, it's very comfortable. It's very happy. It's like the whole theme of the carnival.
Am I not?
The theme is paper mache floats, and each year they pick a King of Moomba from the crowd, and he sort of has to parade around on one of these floats looking rather ridiculous.
I mean, really,
can we do a serious interview with this happening? I don't think we can. I don't think this is going to be possible. I think I made the right move not sitting next to him, actually.
I'm
very fond.
I'm very happy, aren't they? Sunny disposition, the Australians. Do you really think we're like Carmen Miranda? No, I just think you're very happy.
What a marvellous
delivery.
Yes, yes,
no, this is working on your show. Anyway, guys, thank you very much.
Watch this. This is one that... Well, there's a mother of a car, I think that's fair to say. Comes tearing around there. It's a Formula First car, which is a new formula. Driven very competently by a person who I'm about to introduce you to. I didn't think you were going to get here in time. How are you doing? You're right in there. Hang on, watch this. Watch this. A lady in the car. Now, that's brilliant, because I hate people who say things like, woman drivers. Heather Bailey, how are you, my love?
Very well, thank you.
Do you get people saying, woman driver, when you're out driving?
Yeah, all the time.
But you show them how?
Absolutely.
How did you get into this?
My father put me into it.
What did he do?
He did rallycross in Scotland.
Oh, right, so it's in the family. What did he think then when you went... I mean, it's a hairy sport, isn't it? I've said hairy a lot this morning. It's a very dangerous sport, isn't it?
It can be, yeah.
How do you stop it from being dangerous?
Have all the right safety equipment and make sure that everything's checked before you go out to race.
It's a really physical thing, isn't it? I mean, you have to be super fit to do this. What's it like?
Yeah, you do need to be very strong in your arms and in your neck.
I mean, you wear all this fireproof gear. Does it get a bit hot in there?
It does. Very hot.
How hot?
You can lose a lot of weight in a race.
What, sweat?
Yeah.
Really? How much?
I can lose up to a stone in a weekend.
A stone in a weekend?
Yeah.
14 pounds of sweat. Oh, Gordon Bennett. Gordon Bennett, how are you doing in the race then at the moment? How many races are there in a year?
There's 24 in the Formula First Series this year. And we're about race 9 now.
Race 9, how are you doing?
All right, we're at Oulton Park on Monday.
All right, go along, give it a lot of support. Heather, thank you very much indeed. Well driven. You, come with me, because there's something I want to show you from Formula First to a completely different kind of Formula. It's very difficult doing handheld camera work, isn't it? Come with me. I thought you were closer than that. Come here. That was Formula First, and I think it's fair to describe this as Formula Farce.
Yes, sir. You join us now right for the very start of the great bag race. The contestants are ready, the technicians are ready, we're ready. I'm the world champion. Over to you, Rob.
Okay. On your marks, get fresh, go! Right. Gilbert, over to you in the box.
Rob, get inside, get at it. Come on, please, hurry up. Come on.
There's no time to commentate. I must get married. No time to commentate.
Blow the race. Let's just envelope together. Yes. Oh, it's so important. And here they go now. And here he is, the kid in the lead. What a pretentious little fellow he is there in front, and how well he must have trained for this race and how important it is to him. But to me, no, my life is more important, and more important than that is marriage. And I think I can't spell it, though. That's the problem still. Here we go. And I think we're going into the break now. Yeah, we probably are.
Got that?
Back soon.
Break.
really don't remember that much. I just know I wasted a thousand days.
We need protection from this infection. Something to ease this cruel disease. A ray of hope and a new direction. I call to you and you rescue me.
'Cause when you're alone,
some love and some sanity. I know there's thousands all over the nation. I thank the Lord that you rescued me.
'Cause when you're alone, I feel like I'm born again. I'm through going down. Can you have a better friend?
Now, pull. It'll work out these wonderful these machines. I'll show you about these later on. A push.
What?
And a pull.
It's very heavy. It's 40 pounds I'm pushing up and pulling down, you know?
It's nothing. Just keep it going. I'm just off to see whether they managed to catch the overboss and stuff in
Galaxy
Rangers. Yeah.
Well, hang on. Wait for
just
me.
Keep going,
I need
Charlie.
To watch it.
Keep going,
oh.
Charlie.
Welcome back. Thanks, buddy.
What's next?
We rendezvous with Doc and Nico on Tortuna. They're putting out the bait now.
Sir, the Queen of the Crown demands to know what's happened.
Oi.
Tortuna Executive Placement Agency. This is it.
What do you two want?
Some directions, Brappo.
Got a juicy tidbit for the overboss.
Uh-huh.
Those two must be them.
Go to this location outside town. Overboss will be waiting. Tell him I'll be expecting my commission.
Thanks, handsome.
They'll be there soon, Overboss. But I smell a trick of some kind.
Then they'll find out I have a trick for them.
Uh-oh.
Hold it right there, uglies.
Who you calling uglies? Ha! Ha!
Ha!
Now we've got you.
Hey!
Somebody here call for a cab?
You're late!
We've got the goods.
And a meeting with the overboss.
Or his thugs.
Let's go wrap this thing up.
Uh-oh, we've got a tail. Goose, get set for another barrel roll.
Ready.
Hit it!
If there are no further objections, let's go get Overboss.
Brappo sent us.
This way.
Lifeline, go earn your supper and find Overboss.
Yo, Doc!
We want 3 million crowns in cash. Take it or leave it.
And if I refuse?
Last chance, Overboss.
Very well. A deal.
Well now, aren't you being cooperative?
Too cooperative. Well, Doc?
Lifeline, come to me.
Check out this lifeform ID, Doc.
You guessed it, Zachary. He's not Overboss. The orders are coming from him.
You're not as clever as you thought. Take them.
I wouldn't do that. This is a neutron bomb.
You fool! My men are fanatically loyal! I'll come back here! I command you to take them prisoner!
If you shoot, I release this and we all go. Well, who wants to buy it?
Hey, what's your hurry?
Well, Senator Gans.
You sure know how to throw a fundraiser, Senator?
You can't prove a thing. I was merely conducting my own investigation.
Oh, you can swear out a confession at Beta, Senator.
And if I don't?
Tortuna's non-league. We'll have to leave you here.
Leave? Leave me on Tortuna?
Let's see. The Queen's after you. You probably owe Brappo money.
And the competition will know who you are. No, you win. Just don't let them get me.
Well, naturally, Senator.
After all, if we have to, we can always smuggle you out.
Cuffer.
Charlotte, you're not still doing that, are you?
I'm tiring, guys.
Charlotte, you didn't have to do it all the way...
All the way through Galaxy Rangers.
No, you didn't have to do it through Galaxy Rangers.
I didn't.
You didn't.
Why didn't you tell me? Oh, cheers. Well, I'm not doing it anymore, though. I'm sick of these machines. I'll see you later.
Charlotte, just brush the concrete on the way to the ship. Excuse me, mate, really. Come with me, you like these? These are what you might call user-friendly exercise machines. If I stand on here...
Welcome.
Thank you.
Please type in your ID code.
In my case, it's G, A, Z, and enter.
Code dropper.
What?
Is likely and is Mr. Trezor Symphony.
Please stay on scale. Okay. I have removed the hands of the scale. Well, I'm not going to weigh and find out how heavy I weigh. Heather, how are you getting on with this thing? This is quite clever, this, isn't it?
Yeah, great.
Punch in your code. This is great, because this machine, I don't know if you can see that, when you move things up and down, this red light, yellow light is what you are doing, and the red light is what you should be doing. Or something like that. Do you have to work out all the time, Heather?
Yeah.
Would this be a useful thing to work with?
Excellent, yeah.
Yeah? What? It fancies your soda machine. Enough of this. Filth. Come with me. Come with me. Meanwhile, Jane, no, you're a parasender, not a stair-ascender, my love. How are you getting on with that? Is that hard work?
No.
Go on, get the speed up there, girl. You got to punch the speed on that thing. This is great. It's a shame you can't see in the daylight, but these things have got like video displays in front of them as well. So when you're actually running up the stairs, it makes it actually physically look like you are running upstairs. I think that's brilliant. That's very good. Yeah, let's see if there's room for two on here. Probably not. No, obviously not. Right. This is the business, this machine here. This is business. Hang on. Put your feet on the lower one. Low on there, my foot on there like that. I don't know if I can do this. Now, I've been recommended that the best way to work out is, in fact, by climbing stairs, right? Because you get muscles in your body working you didn't even know had butt muscles. But where I live in London, I've got this flat, which is at the top of about 9 million stairs. So somehow I don't think I need something like this. But mind you, if I got to the top and wanted to work my way back to the bottom, this is the way to do it. Hey, I suppose you could call these things a sport aid. It's sport aid.
Just a quick recap on the sport aid competition of last week. Sport aid are trying to find 6 roving reporters to travel to the 6 continents and send back reports telling you how sport aid are helping children in need. Now, if you fancy being a roving reporter for sport aid, then what you have to do is send a 1-minute tape explaining how you would change the world and help people in need. Now, if you fancy that, send it to us at the usual address, but remember to put sport aid at the top of the envelope and inside enclose your name and address and your registration number, because you can't apply unless you've registered for the race against time. Now, let's have a quick recap, see how many people have registered, in fact, so far. Press these buttons. I'm very good on computers these days, you know. We have 18,608. Well done, everyone. Oh, well done, all you out lot out there for registering. Do you know, the biggest block of people to register all at once are all the schools in China. Oh. Now, if they all race on September 11th, there could be a minor earthquake. But it's not just racing, because people are doing all sorts of weird and wonderful things for sport aid, including Laurie McMenemy, who's doing a very strange thing for sport aid. Hello.
Hello,
how are you, Colin?
Gilbert seems to have tired. Whatever
that is. It's a bit naughty. Never mind.
Yes, you have to
straighten. Tell me what. Shut up, you.
Big
a minute.
Laurie McMenemy's here
You've
today, Charlotte.
What exactly have you done for sport aid?
Well, I got a few top managers together to make a record.
Yeah. That's football managers.
The football managers, yes. And
Cluffy.
It's all about, yes, Cluffy's on
Cluffy's
it.
Cluffy's there.
Mr. Cluff to you, please.
Young man.
He's on it, and Bobby Robson's on it, and Teddy Venables.
What's it called?
It's called the worst record ever.
Well,
the worst record in the world.
Actually,
well, let's have a quick look at it
yes,
now.
That'd be
it's made by
have we
the boss.
The boss squad.
That's what you call the boss squad.
Have we?
He's a colour, white's a colour too. Green is a colour, another colour's blue. Have you had enough yet? Are your eardrums fit to burst? Of all the football songs, this is the worst. Oh, so sing it loud, so sing it long. This is the dreadfulest of football songs. Worse than United, worse than the Blues.
Let's face it, Saint, this song is bad.
And there goes the halftime whistle. What an extraordinary whistle it was. And I wouldn't like to be in that dressing room now.
Hey, that was diabolical with a capital D. In all my years associated with this game, I've never seen a display which was such a disgrace. You've let me down, you've let yourselves down, you've let the game down. Now get out there, young men, and show them what you're made of.
Like that.
Oh.
No, you can see the whole of that video, can't you, on the funny side,
funny side
at 6:15
tonight, yes.
Tonight right. On ITV. So if you could bear it, watch it on there. This is the
that's it.
That's the record.
It's spot the managers know. They all when they were very young.
Oh, oh yeah.
There's Jack Charlton there with a lot of hair. Can you see?
Oh.
Barry Davis.
And,
that's
you.
Yes.
Gilbert's in there somewhere.
And it comes with these.
Well, these are whenever you buy a record, it comes with the plugs.
Put it in your ears.
That's right. I think we can give that one a go. But yeah, get rid of that.
And also, you can buy these T-shirts as well, saying.
Yeah, I think it's got to be remembered that all the managers went along here in a very busy time of the season for the charity.
How did you manage to get them all together?
Well, I twisted their arm, a few of them. I mean, I've got more time than some of the others at the minute. I haven't been working for quite a while in football.
You threatened them, Laurie. That's what you mean.
I threatened them with meeting you, actually. And they came along, and simply because it was for Sport Aid. I mean, there was nobody got anything off it. I think Bob Geldof showed the way in the first place, and every department of entertainment, which football is, I think has got to try and do their bit. And I think this is the first time professional football has stood up and been counted. Yeah. Well, let's hope it raises a lot of money.
A good guy for everybody at the end.
Tell me, can you let me into a secret? Who was the most tuneful?
I can tell you who was the worst.
Yeah, who's the worst then? Who is
no,
the
actually, Billy Bingham was a star. He's the manager in Northern Ireland, and if you watch him, he conducts everything. Brian Clough was excellent. He was first class, Brian.
Can he sing?
But
You weren't bad yourself, Laurie. You weren't bad yourself.
Yeah, well, I'm
to
too
go.
Modest to say
you
that.
You look good.
Actually, the puppet was better than Brian. But Terry Venables is a good singer anyway.
And, at the Spurs! At the Spurs!
You've hit a nail on the head. He loves Spurs. I'll leave you two chatting. For now, from one sport to another. It's time for the news from ITN. This week, talking about the world of snooker. Not bad, huh? Just a little shot I've been practicing. You know, they used to say that if you were good at snooker, you'd had a bad childhood. But these days, if you want to play snooker professionally when you're adult, you have to start when you're young. Because by the time you've grown up, it could be too late. Do you recognize this teenager being interviewed by Janet Street Porter about his career prospects?
Are you going to go professional now? I mean,
I hope so, yeah.
Yeah, do you work at all at the moment? I mean, how do you support yourself?
My parents are very nice and they support me. But I win a little bit in tournaments.
Yeah.
But mainly it's from my parents supporting me.
Yeah, you don't win enough yet.
I don't work, no.
But you don't win enough to keep yourself.
No.
But Steve Davis does now. And it's because of play like this. The first time that 147, the highest possible single score, was seen on TV. It allowed him to turn professional at 20 and has made Davis into the greatest modern player of the game. This year, Davis is defending world champion, and if he wins today in Sheffield, he'll be in the final trying for his fifth title. One man who couldn't stop him this year, but who looks set to before long, is Stephen Hendry. The youngest ever winner of the Australian Masters, three times in succession Scottish professional champion. This year he's already won £250,000, but the prospect of lots more to come. He has advertising contracts and a £35,000 Mercedes. He's been playing since he was 12. A year later was regularly making 100-point breaks. He was Scottish amateur champion at 15 and won his first professional championship at 17. Thanks to television and the huge prize money to be won, there are snooker halls across the country full of young players who dream of being like Hendry. At the King's Cross Snooker Club in London, Peter Ebden, at 17, is London's top amateur player. But even for him, there's a long way to go before he can get one of only 10 professional tickets that come vacant every year.
I'm not doing too bad as an amateur. I've won a few tournaments, but really, it's what you do in the tournaments that count in turning professional. And hopefully, I'll be a professional next year anyway.
And when did you first take an interest in the game?
I picked up a cue just before I was 14.
And when did you decide that snooker was going to be the game for you?
Just under a couple of years ago, I decided that I want to play snooker full-time. So that's what I did.
And so did you have to leave school?
I left school, yeah.
And what about your exams?
I didn't sit them.
What did your parents say?
It's gone mad. My mum and dad went mad.
They went mad because 7 million play the game every week at every level, but only a few make a living. And even if you do become one of the 128 professionals, you've got to be in the top 30 to be really well known and rich. Peter Ebden may be one of the lucky ones, but for most of us, being as good as Davis is just a dream.
Snooker, loopy, nuts are we. Me
and him and them and me. We'll show you what we can do with a load of balls and a snooker cue. Pop the wrist in, screw bang for the yellow, green, brown, blue, pink and black. Snooker loopy, nuts are we. We're all snooker loopy.
Sue Carpenter, ITN, for Get Fresh.
Thank you very much.
Is this your
Sue
boy?
Carpenter, thank you.
Now,
did you see that person doing that interview earlier on? Shut up, will you shut up a minute? I'm talking.
Yeah, everyone used to call me a boy.
I don't know. That person doing that interview earlier on, Janet Street Boards, she invented Get Fresh. Now you know. Now you know. Right then, we had a little something earlier on. Little Russ Paul Smith couldn't do the stunt he wanted to do. I think you should be able to see it now. Go on, Paul, off you go, mate. What happened was someone had actually turned the petrol off and his car stalled. Watch this as he comes into here. Over he goes.
Okay.
Isn't that brilliant? Isn't that brilliant? How he does it, I will never know. But look at the stabiliser. Superb. Right then, can you see these people here? Up there? Can you see these people here? Watch this. Have you enjoyed yourselves this morning?
Actually, Gaz, it's been quite good.
Actually, Gaz, it's been quite good. I'm brilliant. Charlotte, what are you doing?
I'm bringing in the procession.
Are you doing, Lee? Front. You still walking, mate?
He's very good at it.
Charlotte, this way, because we've not really finished yet this morning.
Look at the smoke.
This is ridiculous.
The
You're right in there.
Procession.
Fine, we'll keep going.
Watch out.
We can all pretend we're Ian Botham. Watch this. He walks pretty fast. Right, now then, we have not totally finished with everything this morning. Because Get the Record is still running. We're in the final straight.
They're doing extremely well, and they're coming on, and it's coming up, and it's doing really well, and as they come up to the final mark, yes, it's the winner, the small person, Bonacea, in the thing wins. Oh, God, oh, she's winner. Yes, come forward. This is Bonacea, ladies and gentlemen. Bonacea, the winner of the champion bag race.
Athos.
She's beaten Richard.
It's gone.
Over here to
it's gone. Right.
With the team manager. Oh, it's and gone. Look at Richard's I'm bag. Hold on. Okay. On goes the winner's ring. There you are, it's the bottle of, the big bottle of Tizer for the both of you. Okay, start shaking it.
Fantastic.
There they come.
Oh, what an incredible.
The winner of the bag race.
Oh, we can't
yes.
Yes.
Yes, oh, my God. Oh,
come here. Come here. Come here.
Champion bag racer.
What's your name?
Jade.
Jade, congratulations, champion of Get Dressed this morning. That means there's only... Thank you, chaps, for running it. Only one more.
Yes, would you like to just move out of the way?
Come here, you lot. They've got to do Get Dressed.
Because it's the final of Get Dressed. And these lovely ladies who got very wet. Who's in third place, girls?
In third place, we have the meteor.
The meteor over there. Do you want to move down?
I think they should definitely win because they've made this all by themselves without any help from their parents or anything like that.
Well done to you. What are your names?
Simon.
And
Chris.
Chris. It's all done by themselves. What
do
they win?
They are the proud winners.
The smoke is very catching on the throat.
Is
Do-Re-Mi album.
Do-Re-Mi, no, it's actually a single.
And inside.
We've got a Walkman and a T-shirt and a born again single from the Christians.
Well done, there you go.
Have
you got a free arm?
Well.
How about second and first?
Second is over here.
Oh,
is
no.
Excuse me, ladies.
Whoops. What's your. Hello, Mark. You're a real spaceman, aren't you?
Yes.
He's a very convincing
Give
spaceman.
Him his second prize.
And he also wins a Walkman and a T-shirt and a Do-Re-Mi record and a Christian record.
How do you feel on this momentous occasion?
Okay.
I'm first, ladies.
Brilliant. First place.
Must be.
It's the Macintosh girls. Yay.
Yes. Turn around and let everybody at home
look at you.
We've got Mars, Milky Way and Galaxy.
And they've all registered for Sport Aid as well.
They have. Well done.
Thank you very much to you guys. Thank you.
We'll see you. Good luck. And we'll see you in Australia.
Come around this way for a minute.
Follow us.
A couple of things we've got to tell you.
Yes.
First of all, Get Dressed next week.
Is all about knights. Not just knights in armour, but it could be a nightmare or a night out on the town or a nightie.
Or knights in white satin, come as a record. Get it? That kind of thing.
We're in St. Austell next week, down in Cornwall.
So, yeah. So if you live in Cornwall, get yourself down there 9:25 in the morning. Get yourself ready for when we land. Now, can I do my bit? Can I do my little bit? Oh, I've got a little bit
okay.
to. Get dressed. Don't just come in normal outfits. Let your imagination go. Whang! I like doing that.
You do. You do it an awful lot.
I know. I enjoyed it. We've got to say goodbye to Bewley.
We've had a great morning this morning here at the Motor Museum. Thank you, Bewley.
Bye, Bewley.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you, Lord Montague, for the loan of your car park and everything. That's very kind of him.
Come on,
shall we get into the ship?
We're going to get out of here. Out of here. Tomorrow on Get Fresh, 10 o'clock in the morning, William Shatner from Star Trek, the new Captain Patrick Stewart of the new Enterprise, Bananarama, loads of space stuff.
Yeah. I think I'll stay down here and clean up, it's a real mess.
Oh, yeah.
Very well done.
What's happening? Oh, tell me nothing.